Hi, I'm the Tabletop Teacher, and in this series of videos, we're unboxing a whole brick of Marvel HeroClix X-Men Rise and Fall that the great folks at WizKids sent for us to preview. I'm mixing things up a bit in this series. I'm taking a closer look at every figure in each booster with the relatively new player in mind, looking at how each figure could be put to good use, sometimes looking at interesting pairings with figures from recent sets. So here's what we got in the first booster. Hellfire Club Guard, Shi'ar Soldier, Arclight, Brew, and Daken. This Hellfire Club Guard is one of those precious generic common figures you'll want several copies of. 25 points for a running shot, penetrating psychic blast combo is not bad at all. But the main thing is that the Hellfire Club Guard can be used as a bodyguard for other friendly characters with the Hellfire Club keyword, since they grant a mastermind variant to adjacent friendly characters with that keyword. This character can be very useful along the super rare Kate Pryde from House of X, for instance. She didn't have any way to avoid or reduce damage. Now, an adjacent Hellfire Club Guard could take the damage for her and she'll grant steel energy to that guard. Another reason you'll want several of these is if you have the super rare Blackheart from this set. On a successful leadership role, Blackheart can instead generate a Hellfire Club Guard on click number 1. And with the power action, Blackheart can turn all friendly Hellfire Club Guards to their number 9 click, and that has a brutal Charge Flurry Blades Exploit weakness combo with an 11 attack and 3 damage. I want a lot of these. The Shi'ar Soldier is a 20-point, 3-clicks character that starts with Running Shot. To take full advantage of this character's For the Empire trait that generates a Shi'ar Flag light object with a power action, you're going to need the super rare Daken from this set, well, as far as I know at this point. Not only can Daken or Daken generate Shi'ar Soldiers with his leadership variant, but he also has a unique modifier that modifies range plus 1, for friendly Shi'ar characters that occupy or are adjacent to a Shi'ar flag light object. Again, getting several of these Shi'ar soldiers will be good if you have Deathbird, another Shi'ar super rare in this set, is able to use these Shi'ar soldiers as fodder for her mastermind variant, even as they are 4 squares away. So this is another common character we'll want several copies of. Arclight has the Rally trait, which is something new that I'm guessing we're going to see more of in some other sets as well. In essence, what this trait does is place a die on this card so the character can use it later in the game. How does the die get there? In Arclight's case, if a 5 shows up in an opponent's finalized attack roll, you can place a die showing a 5 on Arclight's card. This is called a Rally die. The attack doesn't need to target Arclight per se, it just needs to be an opponent's attack roll. This is what the red background means under the trait star. Once Arclight has this rally die on her card, she can later use it to replace a die in an attack roll when she uses Quake. And she can use Quake for free after resolutions of a close destroy action, that's like destroying a wall or blocking terrain, or hitting a single opposing character. So she could charge, target a single character, and if she hits, she gets to use Quake as a free action. It's like a conditional flurry, if you will. This is not a bad choice as close attackers go for 50 points, especially in popper format games. Brew's special damage power, genius level intellect versus brewed nature, gives him a choice. A free action can grant him either outwit and plus 1 to his defense, or exploit weakness and a plus 1 to his attack. Blades Claws Fangs for the whole dial, but only 10 attack, so that plus 1 to attack is going to be handy. But since he's tiny, a standard character could very well carry him during a running shot or charge or whatever, and drop him in a nice spot to outwit something important after resolutions. Especially useful with other characters that can also use the X-Men team ability so Brew could heal them. It's like carrying a first aid kit that can outwit opposing characters or tear through them with penetrating claws. Not a bad way to spend 40 points. The rarest figure in this booster is Daken, and he is something. His trait is a healer and stop-click killer. When Daken hits, each hit character gets a poison token, which prevents them from healing, and they cannot use their stop-clicks for the rest of the game, even if Daken is knocked out. There is no way to get rid of a poison token, at least not that's mentioned on this card. If you've played against Wendigo from the Dark Phoenix Saga set or Wolverine from the Regenesis set, you'll know how useful this is. Now, on top of this, Daken has the Won't See Me Coming special speed power that grants him stealth, sidestep, and a charge variant that doesn't cut speed in half if he occupies hindering terrain. He has a lot of keywords to work with. I think he can be very satisfying to play. Expect your opponent to target him first if they have healers or stop clicks they're counting on. So, out of these five characters we pulled in this booster, which one are you most excited to play? In which team would you play this character? Let us know which and why in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe, like, share, and support on Patreon. Thanks for unboxing with me.